11-year-old child presented with dysarthria, axial tetuvated imaging showing symmetrical hypointense globus pallidi with hyperintense central area, suggestive of gliosis and necrosis. You also found cavum septum, pellucidum and vergae in this case. FLIR images showing similar findings. Coming to susceptibility weighted imaging, you can see blooming on the bilateral globus pallidi, substantia nigra. Some part of GP is not showing blooming. So metal deposition can sometimes be hyperintense on T1. You can appreciate that finding here. So this is a case of Hallowardene's Parts disease where you could see all the findings. Similar case where you could see classical eye of tiger sign and blooming on susceptibility weighted images. This case was performed on 3 Tesla. This patient had psychiatric disturbances. Neurodegeneration of brain accumulation or Hallowardene's Parts syndrome has been described in 1922 by Julius Hallowardene and Hugo Spatz. The name Hallowardene syndrome became discouraged from use as neurodegeneration with brain iron accumulation because of concerns regarding Hallowardene and Dr. Spatz's affiliation with Nazi regime and their unethical activities surrounding how they obtained many autopsy specimens. Neurodegeneration of brain accumulation can also be called with synonyms, neurodegeneration of brain accumulation type 1, pantothenate kinase associated neurodegeneration, PKAN2, pigmentary degeneration of globus pallidus, substantia nigra and red nucleus, or least preferably called as Hallowardene's Parts syndrome. So it is mainly because of mutation in PKAN2 gene resulting in neurodegeneration with iron accumulation. It is most common second decade of life. Histopathologically, you can see hyperpigmentation in globus pallidi and substantia nigra. These patients present with progressive gait impairment, rigidity of limbs. They can be involuntary movements and dysarthria, like in our case. Chorioathetotic movements and progressive dementia can also be found. There are two types of this syndrome, which is classic early onset rapidly progressive disease, atypical late onset slowly progressive disease. On imaging findings, CT, there can be dystrophic calcification in globus pallidi. MRI shows initial bilateral symmetrical hypointense globus pallidi due to iron accumulation. Later phases, they can be associated hyperintense foci within the globus pallidi secondary to tissue destruction and gliosis. Classical eye of tiger sign, which is nothing but central hyperintensity surrounded by hypointense globus pallidi, can be seen. The left eye of the tiger can be compared with the right side, and the right side eye of tiger can be compared to the left side in the brain. Why there is central T2 hyperintensity? It is mainly because of increased water content resulting in axonal loss, which in turn leads to cavitation by the neutrophils, leading in axonal spheroid formation, which is resulting in high signal within the T2 weighted images. Eye of tiger sign on globus pallidi can also be seen in cases of Wilson's disease, atypical Parkinsonism, organophosphate poisoning, and also in normal brain on 3 Tesla imaging. So finally, take home points from this case are: always keep differentials in mind whenever you see eye of tiger sign. Also understand the pathophysiology and the signal changes resulting in eye of tiger sign. Thank you very much. Hope this video was useful for you.